In this video, we will examine five types of unemployment and the causes of each. Structural unemployment occurs when there is a mismatch between the skills workers have and the skills that are demanded by firms. For example, if you were highly experienced at repairing video cassette recorders, you probably became structurally unemployed when DVD players became commonplace. Structural unemployment is a significant concern for governments, as making efficient use of labor resources helps an economy be more productive and thus more competitive globally. By addressing structural unemployment and the geographical and occupational immobilities of labor, the government can help reduce structural unemployment. And as mentioned in a previous video, structural unemployment can be addressed with supply-side policy. How exactly, we'll see in a later video. Frictional unemployment occurs when workers are between jobs. It also includes new graduates entering the labor force and seeking out their first job. Frictional unemployment is part of any healthy economy and is typically not a major concern for governments. Seasonal unemployment occurs when workers are only employed for certain seasons of the year or certain times of the year. For example, retailers will increase hiring in the run-up to Christmas and then release workers shortly after. Cyclical or demand deficient unemployment occurs when aggregate demand is below the full employment level of output. For example, in a recession, the reduction in aggregate demand causes a fall in the demand for labor, resulting in cyclical unemployment. Cyclical unemployment is a key concern for government and can be addressed with monetary and fiscal policy. Let's see what cyclical unemployment looks like on a diagram. Suppose the economy was initially in short run and long run equilibrium at YFE. If aggregate demand falls and actual output falls to Y2, this results in a negative output gap. The fall in the aggregate demand for goods and services will then decrease the demand for labor, resulting in cyclical unemployment. Real wage or classical unemployment occurs when wages are not able to fall to a point at which labor markets can clear. If demand is falling throughout an economy and wages are prevented from falling, real wage unemployment arises. The concept of sticky wages helps us understand this a bit better. Let's use the minimum wage to explain this. Suppose the labor market for factory workers is in equilibrium at W1QS. Also, assume that W1 happens to be the minimum wage. If demand drops further for manufactured goods, the demand for labor will fall as well. However, the wage rate cannot adjust to W star and must legally remain at W1. This will result in an excess supply of labor and thus real wage or classical unemployment. That wraps up this video on the types of unemployment. It's a straightforward topic, but you may have some questions. If you do, leave a comment or question below and let's try and answer it together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.